Hey folks, my name is Keith Sugandasa and welcome to OpenSRE. Today we are going to talk about what is Site Reliability Engineering, or short for SRE. Alright, before we try to understand the word SRE, let's try and understand the term called DevOps. Back in the day, software engineering organizations had two primary units in terms of development and operations. So one side we had the developers, and on the other side we had the operations engineers. So the main responsibility of the developers was to deliver the features, deliver the code, and put those deliveries from the development side to the operation side of it. So the operations engineers, their responsibility was to maintain this code, do the deployments, and make sure it's running well in production. So this responsibility gap, because of this responsibility gap, the developers thought their main responsibility was just to deliver the features, and they will not worry about the quality and reliability because they were assuming that it would be a responsibility of the operations engineers. So because of this confusion, what happened? The developers started giving out a lot of code without worrying about the quality and reliability of those deliveries. And on the other side, the operations engineers, they started getting a lot of code which they could not manage in a proper development lifecycle. Because of this reason, the developers started giving out a lot of code to the operations engineers, and the operations engineers started putting out quality gates to make sure that the speed of deliveries get reduced so that they have enough time to manage the deployments. This confusion or this responsibility gap that we see in organizations is called the wall of confusion. The wall of confusion has other different meanings, but primarily, this is the reason why there are two different responsibilities and there's a gap and barrier in between teams like developers and operations. To break this barrier, to break this responsibility gap that we see between developers and operations, we introduced a concept called DevOps. DevOps is where developers and operations teams work together to make sure that there's a shared responsibility in starting the code and delivering the code into production. Now that we understand what DevOps is all about, let's try and understand what SRE is. SRE is what happens when you ask a software engineer to implement an operations function in a software engineering perspective in your organization. Well, in object-oriented concepts, object-oriented terms, SRE implements DevOps. If we consider DevOps as an interface and SRE as a class, SRE will implement the interface called DevOps. As we know, different organizations have different DevOps practices. But what if we bring in a software engineering mindset to tackle problems like DevOps? This is what we call SRE. So different organizations have different DevOps practices, and the way that the software engineers will implement these DevOps practices will also be different. This is why we call that SRE has different flavors in different organizations. SRE is not the same in every organization, and it can be having a lot of a variety of coding styles, a variety of practices, and different guidelines and set of activities when it comes to SRE in different organizations. So now that we understand what SRE is, let's try and understand a few examples on how SRE can engineer activities like DevOps. SREs could basically automate alerting, they could automate response handling via playbook automations, they can have tooling around high severity incident management to handle proper pipelining, CI/CD automations, and a lot of activities like this can be automated. So what happens is we build a software engineering infrastructure around our existing infrastructure, and this is what we call the SRE ecosystem. Something important to understand here is also that SRE is not just about DevOps. SRE plays a major role in every life cycle in a software. For example, starting from requirements, to design, to development, to deployment, maintenance, all these stages, SRE plays a major role. That's why we say that SRE has different flavors in different organizations. Sometimes you may be doing SRE without even being explicitly called an SRE. That's how different it is in different organizations. And Google has given you a set of books and guidelines on how to implement SRE in your organization, but you can also think of doing it in your own way. As long as you bring a software engineering mindset to make sure that production systems are reliable, that's what we call SRE. So in the next few videos, we'll start talking about the basics of SRE, like concepts like SLOs, SLIs, and SLAs. I'll see you in the next video. Have a good day.